Hello and welcome. You're watching Market Head Start on Money Control. I'm Sakshi Batra and this is where we get you prepared for the trading setup of the day. I also have with me Kshitij Anand. He's the Markets Editor at Money Control. Good morning, Kshitij, and thanks very much for joining in. It's the last trading day of this week. We've had a good week so far, especially the last 2 days when we've seen the 12,000 mark on the Nifty and two consecutive days when we've seen record high levels being created on the Sensex as well. So, Kshitij, could you help us understand what were the big factors that led to the rally and to the fresh record highs on the markets yesterday, as well as what are the big cues for today?
Morning, Sakshi, and good morning, viewers. Well, definitely positive news coming from both domestic as well as global front helped, Sensex hit a fresh record high, while Nifty 50 also managed to, close above 12,000 levels for the first time since June now. If you look at today's trading session, I think global cues are slightly on the downside. I think it'll be a day of profit taking. Why we say that is, although there is a deal in place with respect to, US and China, but if you look at the Asian markets as well as SGX Nifty, there's some bit of a downtick that we are seeing. In fact, Asian markets are also trading with muted buys. So what we are seeing at this point in time is today could be a day of profit taking because we're already trading near crucial resistance level. There's one more headwind for Indian markets, and that is Moody's rating action on India. Now, they have actually lowered the rating, in fact, lowered the guidance from stable to negative. Now, this is something which could act as a headwind for Indian markets, slightly disappointing per se at this point in time. But if you look at the foreign institutional investors, they remain positive. In fact, non-bought a little over 900 odd crores were poured into Indian markets in yesterday's trading session. Rupee closed flat. So all in all, I think, Sakshi, it will be a day of some bit of profit taking.
Yeah.
But we have a crucial support near 11,800 levels, and that should, if in case we do, come close to that level, I think we should see a bounce back around about that.
Absolutely.
Level.
So there are a whole lot of macro factors that we'll be looking at apart from this. If you actually see the 12,000 level, whether it gets protected or not, will be seen. And if not, if consolidation takes place, then 11,800 will be the crucial support to watch out for. Apart from this, back domestically, we'll just have to focus on the earnings. About 200 companies will be reporting their earnings.
Right.
A lot of mid-cap, small-cap names will be coming out with their names. But I'm sure some of the large caps like FMCG and auto names will be something which will be on your radar today.
Absolutely. Well, all in all, there are around about 180 companies on the BSE which will be declaring their results for the September quarter. Now, the prominent one being Nestle India. Here, the net profit is likely to grow by nearly 10% on a year-on-year basis. For Eicher Motors, the PAT is likely to fall by 20% on a year-on-year basis. And from the auto space, we have Mahindra and Mahindra. Here, the net profit is likely to fall by over 12% on a year-on-year basis. Now, remember, all the estimates are from Motilal Oswal.
All right, so those will be the important numbers to watch out for. But apart from this, we'll also have to remember the technical patterns and the technical charts. What are they indicating and the crucial levels to watch out for the index today as well. So, Kshitij, help us with that.
Right. So, in fact, even though, we see a headwind with respect to Moody's rating action on, India, wherein it has been brought down to negative from stable. But if you look at the chart patterns at this point in time, in the last trading session, that means in Thursday's trading session, Nifty formed a dragonfly doji kind of a candle, which essentially means it's more of an indecisiveness among the bulls as well as the bears, which was followed by something known as bullish candle. But at this point in time, what essentially investors have to look at the crucial support levels. Now, I'll probably go slightly deep into the crucial support levels because the downtick that we could see in today's trading session, probably in the opening trade, could be around about 50 odd points. So definitely 11,800 is something which investors should watch out for on the downside. Apart from that, on the higher side, investors should watch out for levels such as 12,021. If in case we are able to hold on to that 12,000 levels, or if in case we are able to bounce back from the 5 days exponential moving average that is placed at 11,946, I think I'll say it's a win day. But if in case we are not able to do that, at 11,900, 11,850 are your crucial support levels to watch out for. And the crucial bit of resistance is still at the record high, which is 12,103.
All right. And apart from this, there's another big news that you will all have to focus on. Well, MSCI has actually announced some of the changes in its India as well as global index. So, Kshitij, what are these changes and from when it will come into effect now?
Right. In fact, there are a lot of stocks which will be in focus in today's trading session. In fact, MSCI has added 8 stocks and deleted around about 6 stocks from MSCI India index. Now, the changes will come into effect from November 26th. post-market closing. So additions include Berger Paints DLF, HDFC AMC, ICICI Prudential, IGL Info Edge, as SBI Life Insurance, as well as Siemens. Now, the stocks which got deleted from the index were BHEL, India Bulls Housing Finance, L&T Finance, Vodafone Idea, as well as Yes Bank. Now, MSCI has also added 8 stocks and deleted 4 stocks from the MSCI Global Standard Index. Now, additions include Berger Paints, Colgate, DLF, ICICI Prudential, HDFC AMC, SBI Life, as well as Siemens. Now, deletions, or the stock which got deleted, were Glenmark, India Bulls Housing Finance, as well as Yes Bank.
All right, so indicative reactions on these particular stocks will also be seen in today's trading session right after this announcement has come. But apart from this, a whole lot of other stocks also will be in focus because of the kind of earnings they have already reported and because of the kind of news flows as well. So, Shirish, top stocks on your radar today?
Right. So the first stock that we have on the list is DLF. In fact, it reported a 19% increase in consolidated net profit at rupees 445 crores. The stock will also be in focus because of the MSCI changes that has happened. It has been included in about 2 indices. Apart from that, IGL will be in focus. Now, the company reported, in fact, doubled its September quarter net profit, so we could see some bit of positive reaction on that. Raymond will be in focus. Now, the company announced the restructuring of its core lifestyle business into separate entity. Now, every shareholder of Raymond will be issued the shares of a new company in the ratio of 1:1. Now, apart from that, Sakshi, I also believe that you're also tracking some stocks based on what brokerages are recommending.
Absolutely. So there's 2 stocks on my list as well. So the first one is HPCL, which has reported its earnings. Now, Citi has come out with its report on this one. It maintains a buy rating. The target price they have given is 360 rupees per share. This target has been increased from the previous target of 345. The current market price of the stock is 310 rupees. So slight uptick from there is what you can expect on this stock. Now, the results were slightly weak from the estimates of our city is what they are saying, but weak refining has actually offset the stable marketing performance this time around. Now, apart from this, city is also keenly tracking this given the company's rising capex intensity. Apart from this, from the pharma space, Sun Pharma also came out with its earnings yesterday, and city again has come out with its report on this one. It maintains a buy rating. The target price now they have given is 540 rupees per share. Now, they also say that the worst appears to be behind the generics business. Also, meaningful pickups in the growth rates remain quite elusive from here on. The commentary remains positive, but difficult to gauge the pace of the ramp up from here on is what Citi is maintaining. Apart from this, we also have some technical recommendations for you. So, Shitish, who have you spoken to and what do we have for today?
Right. Well, to make your day more profitable, we spoke to India Nivesh Securities Limited. They've given us 3 recommendations for today. Now, the first stock that they have on the list is Bharat Electronics. Now, that's a buy for a target of 118 and a stop loss of 103. Apollo Hospitals, that's also a buy for a target of 1550 and a stop loss of 1400. RIL, that's a sell with a target of 1390 and a stop loss of 1500. Now, remember, the return potential is close to 4-8% on all the 3 stocks. These are not intraday trading ideas, but more of a position play. So in case you initiate any positions based on these recommendations, well, do consult your financial advisor.
Right. Thanks a lot, Shitish, for sharing these bright ideas with us. And with that, it's a wrap here on this edition of Market Head Start. You stay logged on to moneycontrol.com for more news and updates. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.